Today on Teamy Outdoors, we float fish the Florida flats with the new ELCO Electric 9.9, teamed up with the SeaArk Boat, one of the stealthiest and most effective way to creep you up on your fish. On American Comrades, Captain Phil and Captain Dan fly fish the Oak Orchard for Monster Browns with U.S. Army veteran Brian Eisch. Also on American Comrades, we hunt with the Miracle Marine, Eddie Ryan, for Siki Deer. Keep it right here.
Outdoors, presented by Slay Odor Neutralizer.
Hey folks, welcome to Teamy Outdoors, presented by Slay. I'm Captain Rick, and we got an awesome show for you today. Today we're down in Florida, demonstrating the ELCO electric motor, teamed up with the SeaArk boat, and of course, fishing with the Sheffield rod and Gamma line. Today we're out here with the brand new ELCO 9.9 electric motor, a lethal combination down here for stealth, no fumes, and no pollution. I'll tell you more a little bit later. But first, let me take you to my rum buddies up north who have a special trip with a veteran named Brian Eisch on Oak Orchard for giant browns.
Oak Orchard is one of the tributaries of Lake Ontario, so we get all the species that are indicative of the lake in here. But at this time of year, the first couple weeks of November, the salmon are almost done their spawn, and the big browns are coming in to gorge themselves on the salmon eggs before they spawn and then return back to the lake.
So more wrist, right?
Yep, more wrist than arm.
I'm trying to keep my elbow tight. A lot different than bass fishing, that's for sure. Just feels good to get out on my leg. On the prosthetic, I've only been in a little over a month.
Brian is a big bass fisherman, but he had never had a fly rod in his hand. He's never fished for trout before. So it took us a little while this morning with a couple of lessons and demonstrating some casting, but he's a fisherman at heart, so it didn't take long for him to catch on.
Got him.
Got him, there you go. That's a brown trout, it's going on the wall. Oh! Hate when that happens.
It was pulling like mad reel.
Well, as I started to teach Brian how to fly fish, the first thing I tell people is take everything you see on television with the fancy back cast and then the double haul cast and just put that out of your mind for now, because it's a little bit simpler the way that we nymph for these trout. You're only casting 15 or 20 feet in front of you, and it's very simple to learn. There he is. All right, Brian. That's it, Brian. You want to keep that rod parallel with the water.
Ooh, that's a
big one. Put some pressure on him. When I tell you to, I want you to take the rod up.
Okay,
that'll lift his head up. I'll be able to get this net on him. Lift his head up if you can right now. There you go.
That's a big one.
Good job, buddy.
Thank you.
Once we showed him the basics, then he didn't need a guide anymore. He had it figured out all on his own. That's what we're talking about there, buddy.
That's a nice fish.
That's a beauty. See his big kite? It's amazing, these fish will develop that kite to spawn and to fight off the other males, and then when he goes back to the lake, it goes away.
Some people think this is gross, but in the bass world, you gotta kiss your fish.
There you go.
Good job, buddy.
This morning, we were a little concerned about Brian getting his feet wet, being that he wears the prosthetic leg, but Brian said to me, as long as he's catching fish, he won't complain one bit about having wet feet.
I was in Walter Reed and had a doctor come in, and he says, hey, look, you're never gonna run again. Your military career is pretty much over. And, you know, that was kind of a shock, because, you know, I was thinking, you know, I can still do this, but, you know, it's what I've done since I was 17 years old. So it's kind of like, hey, you're done. So I was just talking to a friend of mine, and he's like, you ever done bass fishing? I said, yeah, I did a tournament. I had a lot of fun. He goes, you should get into bass fishing. So I bought a boat. So I basically took 100% Army to 100% bass fishing, and I just went with it. I got this mentality, as long as I keep making improvements and keep progressing and just, I don't know, enjoy life. Can't go wrong. It's better than going the other way.
The sacrifices these guys have made for our country and the pain that they've endured, it's an honor to be in the water with them and hear their stories. It's something totally different that you just gotta have the utmost respect for them.
Got him. Fish on.
Locked.
Keep pressure on him.
The trick with these fish is once you hook them, to hold pressure, because they can spit the hook really quick.
Making a run. Phil goes to net him. You're going to lift up straight up on the reel. Try and walk his head right into the net. So mend in like you were going to do.
Now this is fun. That's a decent
Staying
size.
Off that line. That is a good one. Rod tip up. Nice and high. Nice and high. Nice and high. There he is.
Kaboom!
This is more of a workout than going to the gym. Ooh, that's got some size to him.
Yep. Girthy.
The tributaries in Western New York are truly world-class brown trout fishing. The average brown trout in Oak Orchard is somewhere between 3 and 7 pounds, but we always manage to get a couple that are in the 10, 12, 14, even up to 16, 18 pound range.
Good deal.
Thank you.
There we go. Back to your friends, buddy.
Team E Outdoors is brought to you by Slay Odor Neutralizer. Welcome to the world of precision scent control. NASCAR Racing Experience, the authentic racing experience. All Season Sports, your single equipment source for New York's Salmon River. The Great Outdoors, your RV superstore in Fulton, New York. By Sheffield Products, when precision counts. Spectra Shot, this shotgun shell eliminates doubt. J. LaFleur Logging and Forestry Products, providing you with all your forestry needs. Finger Lakes Tire, we carry every tire you will ever need. Gamma Line, all fishing lines are not created equal.
Bow hunting requires getting in close, and controlling human scent can often be the difference between success or failure. So don't cover human odor, eliminate it with Slay. Slay's scientific formula kills the bacteria that causes odor and keeps working all hunt long. This new Slay Pro-Line kit comes with everything you need to neutralize and eliminate human odor. Log on to slaythegame.com now and learn how Slay can get you back in the game. So don't cover human odor, eliminate it with Slay.
On the water, you've got to beat Mother Nature to beat the odds.
Oh, yeah.
ScoutLookWeather.com has a new fishing app that is changing the game. The new free Bassmaster Fishing app puts weather, wind maps, solunar times, and tides at your fingertips. The FishLog app lets you catch fish, snap a photo, and capture weather details automatically. View, edit, and analyze your logs free online.
So don't just get the outlook, get the scout look.
Hey Phil, I've been getting some tweets as to why us run captains have been using Gamma Line.
Dan, what the heck is a tweet?
Higher breaking strength, cast longer with accuracy, more natural presentation.
Meat, baby! Hey, you catch more fish, guaranteed.
Your time on the water is too valuable to be compromised by your line's performance.
NASCAR Racing Experience, the authentic racing experience. Packages start at just $329. Thrilling.
Yeah!
The Rush. The NASCAR Racing Experience. Call 1-877-RACELAP today.
Captain Rick here for All Season Sports in Pulaski, New York. Whether you're on the Salmon River
or in Alaska,
whether you're trolling Big Lake, Ontario for Dime Bright Kings, or your style is fly fishing or spin gear fishing on the Salmon River,
woo!
All Season Sports is your single source for fishing equipment.
Fish on, baby, fish on!
Stop in or shop online at allseasonsports.com. Tell them Captain Rick sent you. Fish on!
The official plumbing, electrical, heat, and air conditioning specialist of Team E Outdoors is Town Mechanical, serving Central New York with over 40 years of experience. Visit us at aroundtownplumbingandheating.com.
Yeah, I think about 9 years ago, the St. Mary's Archers Club opened their facilities to the public and started serving breakfast and lunch.
This year we started September 27th and it ends next Tuesday, November 11th, Veterans Day. It runs the Veterans Day every year.
Most of the gentlemen there are veterans. When I mentioned the fact that we were shooting an episode with a wounded vet, fellas at the Archers Club, they really got excited and wanted to know what they could do to help and make it a smooth transition for everybody. And they really bent over backwards for us as usual.
Thanks a lot for coming. I'm glad you're enjoying yourself. And
you
I'm a fellow
awesome.
Veteran. There's a fellow veteran.
Well, thanks Vietnam for your veteran. Service. Thanks for your service.
He's probably gone through a lot, so it helps him out a great deal. You're healing in both ways, you know, mentally and physically. And we're glad to see him here.
Getting better than this right here.
When I got out, I was a platoon sergeant for an infantry scout platoon, so I had three sniper teams and two recon teams. Had a good group of soldiers, had an amazing medic. He saved my life for all intents and purposes. When I went out to save that police officer, he was right there to help me when I got hit. So, you know, I want to get back to being active. I think, you know, being out here fishing helps a lot with that, getting active. You know, now that I got my prosthetic, I'm starting to get confidence back.
I think what Brian learned today is with the skills that he's picked up today, he'll be able to go anywhere in the country or the world and fish. He caught on good, and I think that now he's got a hobby that'll last him a lifetime.
Taking out our returning vets is a privilege for all of us, not to mention the greatest therapy that they can possibly have. It's been a mission statement for all of us here at the production house at Team E Outdoors.
Up next,
we hunt Siki Deer with Miracle Marine, Eddie Ryan.
Hurrah!
Bow hunting requires getting in close, and controlling human scent can often be the difference between success or failure. So don't cover human odor, eliminate it with Slay. Slay's scientific formula kills the bacteria that causes odor and keeps working all hunt long. This new Slay Pro Line kit comes with everything you need to neutralize and eliminate human odor. Log on to slaythegame.com now and learn how Slay can get you back in the game. So don't cover human odor, eliminate it with Slay.
Sportsman, if you need tires for your 4x4, SUV, ATV, or boat trailer, Finger Lakes Tire is the place to go. Located in Auburn, New York, our mission is to deliver the most professional, hassle-free, and pleasant purchase experience anywhere. We offer real value on quality tires and have over 5,000 tires in stock every day. Located in Auburn, New York, Finger Lakes Tire, your neighborhood tire store.
Captain Rick here for All Season Sports in Pulaski, New York. Whether you're on the Salmon River,
or in Alaska!
Whether you're trolling Big Lake, Ontario for Dime Bright Kings, or your style is fly fishing or spin gear fishing on the Salmon River.
Woo!
All Season Sports is your single source for fishing equipment.
Fish on, baby, fish on!
Stop in or shop online at allseasonsports.com. Tell them Captain Rick sent you. Fish on! We've been getting a ton of response through email about the centerpin fishing itself. You know, a couple people live in Alaska or the West Coast, you know, Rick, I can't come out, I can't come to the Sam River and fish with you, we want to learn. So we went ahead and took the liberty of making an in-depth learning video for centerpin, and which you can pick up online, which is listed below me here. You know, hopefully you'll get into it too, no matter where you are in the country, this is a great system. Hope to see you soon on the water. Fish on!
The official gun shop of Team E Outdoors is Intimidator Sports in Nedro, New York. We look forward to providing your hunting and shooting needs. Visit us at intimidatorsports.com.
Welcome back to Team E Outdoors presented by Slay. I'm Captain Rick. The advantage of this new ELCO Electric 99 is limitless. duck boats, bow fishing, flat fishing. It will get you on the fish or ducks or anything you want to use it for with no noise. And us as captains, fishing in shallow water, we know no noise means no spooking fish. Folks, I'm Captain Rick, host of numerous national outdoor shows. I am in Florida today, joined by Dean Heineman, who is the director of sales for ELCO Electric Motors. Dean, why are we here today?
Captain Rick, thank you for having me. We're here to demonstrate the clean power, torque, and efficiency of our ELCO Electric 9.9.
Today we are on a SeaArk boat that was kindly donated to us for this demonstration by Old Salt Marine at a Lakeland, Florida. We are on the RXT180. This particular model is 18 foot long with an 82 inch beam, 60 inch bottom, and weighs approximately 500 pounds empty.
One of the great benefits of an electric motor is the fact that you have immediate torque at 1 RPM. And with an electric motor, what you want to optimize is speed and torque. And that's where ELCO's focus has been in the development of our electric outboards. We have an obligation to take care of our environment. We've seen improvements in buildings. We've seen improvements in cars. And now ELCO is making great advancements in electric propulsion in the marine industry. At ELCO, we're committed to being the leader in electric propulsion for the marine industry. We offer the broadest range of electric and hybrid propulsion options out of any company in the world.
Up next is Eddie Ryan, known as the Miracle Marine, who actually died twice on the table. We're gonna get him back in the outdoors and back to what he likes to do.
Hey, buddy. What's happening,
hey,
man?
Hey, buddy.
Good to see you again.
Eddie.
He remembers Mark from the Buffalo.
Yeah. When was it you shot the Buffalo? Remember that big thing? That thing was huge, wasn't it?
He hit it three times. Yeah. Remember the third shot it went down?
Go down. Finally.
Three times.
Yeah. That's awesome, bud.
Every day, me and Angie, we just feel blessed that we have our son. We had a second chance. It was a very close call, and you know, he's our Miracle Marine.
So we got a bigger challenge today. We got a Sika buck. I know you tried for a Sika buck before and you couldn't get him.
Twice. Yep.
So we're gonna try again. We're not gonna give up either. We're gonna get him.
No, there's no
I can feel it. What do you think? Yeah, he's a good one too. He's a nice 4x4. He's big, he's got beautiful spots.
Let's make it happen.
Oh, we're
Let's
gonna,
make it happen,
yes.
Captain.
He should just be coming out of velvet, and if he's not, he actually, his horns look a little bigger, so you could have him mounted in velvet or out of velvet. It's up to you.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Let's make it happen.
We're gonna get you up there. We're gonna get him in front of you, and you gotta make the shot.
Yep, we'll do.
All right. Well,
you have no problem with doing
you
that.
You got that part down. Excellent.
Yeah. Eddie was in Iraq in a small town in Husaba, on a Syrian border, on his third tour of duty. His third tour of duty, he was a Marine sniper on a rooftop, and unfortunately, friendly fire engaged, and he was wounded. He was severely wounded. Two shots to the head. The one bullet that really, you know, severely wounded him was the one I went through his left eyebrow, went through his brain and took out the front portion of his brain. Thank God we had the, you know, there was brave Marines over there that, as we're told in their, you know, the recommendation for the medal, the one Marine crawl to Eddie's body under intense machine gun fire with total disregard for his own life. And he's our hero. Carl Schaefer's our hero. He saved Eddie, and the rest of the Marines got him off of the roof. He was flown to Germany, Landstuhl, Germany, and he was on life support. That's when the Marine Corps flew me, my wife, and my daughter out to basically say goodbye to Eddie. And, you know, we got there, we didn't even recognize him. And 5 days it took to stabilize him in Landstuhl, Germany. And then he was flown on a low flight because of brain injury. We were flown to Bethesda, Maryland. From there on in, we just, day by day, he got stronger, day by day. You know, he fought to live for us, and we thank God for that.
We got a nice fall day, too.
Yep. Uh-huh.
We're gonna see some nice elk, some red deer,
yep,
and a zebu, the craziest thing I've got up there.
One, two, three, go!
Good job, Ray.
Okay, we got you. Got you. Good. He's on Marine. Nice and slow, baby. Slow and easy. Beats fast and furious every day. Come on. We do what's good for him, and that's why we're here. Just enjoying a day with him and hunting and doing things that he used to do. Opening up his world.
Team E Outdoors is brought to you by Higdon Outdoors. Get real. Rig'em Right Waterfowl, heavily seasoned. Momarsh, hardcore hunting products. Molt Gear, hunt hard, hunt alive. Lucky Duck Premium Decoys, masters of deception. Striker Brands Blind Camo. Copper John Bow Sights, nothing tougher.
We've seen a big difference in the outdoors. I think it helped Eddie in his recovery because at one point we couldn't hunt because he would, with the brain injury, there was a time where he would shake his head uncontrollably and scream. And you just can't hunt like that, you know? Even in a ground blind, we just couldn't do it. But after going in the woods and attempting to hunt, and you know, he gained self-discipline, and it, you know, trying to hunt these animals, he had to focus on getting better and rehabbing and just remembering all that he used to do to hunt and be successful. And little by little, it didn't happen quick, months and years. Now we're at a point where he'll sit and he'll watch for the animal and he'll spot the animal and he'll wait for the right opportunity and he can wait it out. Well, this is the third time Eddie tried for a seeker buck. They're kind of elusive, kind of spooky. The big challenge was mobility, you know, getting him in position for the shot without spooking the deer. Yeah, they're probably about 150 yards away, 100, 125 yards, just out of sight.
Well, there's another trail on that side. What we'll do, we'll go around that trail and come through, okay, and then as they see us over there, they still may come out to the field.
Okay. Right before dark, right?
Yeah. Let's load up. And there's some other trails down there. We might get lucky and get them in some open woods where you can still get a shot at them.
Okay.
You know, we're running out of time a little bit, but we'll push it right to the end, do what we can.
Yeah, we'll do what we can.
Mm-hmm. Right, buddy?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
The way we were positioned in with the chair, it was kind of awkward because there was some equipment in the way. It was a good shot, but it was a narrow shot, and we got lucky. We got lucky. The animal stopped in a decent clearing, and Eddie was able to pull off the shot.
He's right in the steer wheel. Wait.
Don't shoot yet.
Wait, put your finger on it. Wait.
He did it, he pulled it off. Thank God.
You shot him.
I had lost him, and then you guys shot. That's awesome.
High five, baby. Come on, give me some skin, Marine. Hurrah, hurrah.
Hurrah.
I'm concerned about him, you know? Like, hey, Ed, you all right? You comfortable? He's like falling out of the chair, getting bit by mosquitoes, but the kid will never complain. He just, I'm good, Dad, I'm good, you know? He's like 151% Marine. Proud of him, man. We're lucky we have him. He's just happy. He's doing the things that he used to do. With the help of Mark Clark and the others, he made it all possible. With this lodge, it's all accessible. And we're gonna sleep here tonight. We're gonna have a good time. The party ain't over. You know, it's just starting.
It's good to give back and say thanks for all the work you did over there, you know? It's something we love to do, and we appreciate you coming up and hunting with us.
You know, one of his favorite sayings is the story ain't over, you know? And that's, it gives us hope as a family, because he's not quitting. There's no quitting. Vocabulary. He's just 151% Marine.
All right, buddy.
Yeah.
Well, arm wrestle, I don't know if I can do that arm.
Okay, folks, thanks for tuning in, and please remember to thank all veterans if you run into them. I'd like to specially thank Old Salt Marine for supplying us with the SeaArk Boat, ELCO Electric Motors, and of course, my good friend, Sheffield Rod and Reels. And being Mom's birthday, she always said, take off the hat. So till next week, folks, to give you a big fish on, I'm Captain Rick. Thanks for tuning in.